property always felt so out of reach to me. You know, especially in Bristol, the house prices, as more and more people come to the city, there's more and more demand for the housing, it pushes the prices up. And the house prices just go further and further out of the reach, to the point where it's very hard to get on the property ladder. You need a significant amount of money, you know, for a deposit, and that's hard. But that's one of the benefits of joint venturing, as we're doing. There's six of us, and we're pooling our resources together. Not just our cash, but our time and our knowledge, and everyone's gonna be doing different roles. So there's an efficiency to that. We can get more done as a six than any one of us would do individually. You know, individually, we might never do any of it. But the reality is, as a six, we will. And with the coaching of Alex, we will, for sure.
But what's really powerful for all of you is to go, what have we got, and pile it all in here and multiply it. And do the work together, rather than Dan's got a limited company over there and paying $2,000 a year limited company accounts or whatever it costs, and you've got one and that's $2,000 over there, and then Ben does it and Wayne doesn't. You all go off and you do your own things, and then you kind of do a bit in the middle here. It's like, if you all put all of that into this, you'd only have $2,000 of accountancy fees,
yeah,
but you'd buy six times more property. I actually have envy of all of my groups, because I technically do it on my own.
Yeah.
So I actually watch you guys do deals, like the group last week that bought the two properties. They bought the one in Newport and the one up in the valley. So I was like, man, I have such envy right now, because you guys are like doing it. And I'm like, I don't actually have a JV group. That's so insane. I do, because there's Owen and we're about to buy a block of flats and blah, blah, blah. But it's not the same as what you guys have.
So we went through a 4-month preparation period with Alex, because that's the way she does it. Because when she brings a group of people together to do property investing as a joint venture group, there's a lot. It's a significant investment of time and resources and energy. You know, there's a lot at stake, and it has to be done thoroughly, and it has to be done correctly, not just with the legal paperwork and all that side of things, like shareholders agreements and wills and, you know, getting all the, there's that as well, but in terms of the interpersonal relationships between the group, what we did in that 4-month period, we went through a period of coaching where we were focused on money and wealth, our relationship to money, sorting out our personal finances, getting everything in order, getting everything organized. But also, it's a period of learning to understand each other, because everyone's got different personalities, and you got to figure out, what's everyone good at? What are they not good at? Which bits do they enjoy? What do they not enjoy? You know, what's everyone's nature? It takes time to figure out everyone and figure out how you're going to work as a team.
It's different. If there are people who are like, look, I just don't want the hassle. I don't want to deal with it. I've got the money. Yeah. Just give me my interest rate. Fine. If you've got people who are looking at doing it anyway, the best thing that they can do is work with me, and then I'll set you up as joint venture partners with everyone's interests, because he could make a lot more with his money than he's going to if he just goes and buys one property at 150, and it could highly benefit you that he may be able to invest in the property as a JV with you guys 50-50. He puts the money in, you put the time in, you do the property, he gets his money back, you get your half of the profit. Something like that instead. You know, for people who want to do property, you need to get them involved on a bigger kind of cut of the deal.
So we've been through that intro period. That's, she calls it money mastermind. But now we're bringing in joint venture mastermind, which is where the rubber meets the road. We're going to do a range of different stuff. We're going to do renovations and conversions and rent to rent and serviced accommodation and anything we can get our hands on, really. But we're going to start off with something that's a suitable size, just as a warm-up, just as a practice, just to go through the process, you know.
These are all steels, so there's a huge steel going across there, and there's a huge steel going across there, and the stairs used to be here. So this was just, the walls that we took out were scary. I mean, the structural engineer said, make sure you're on this side of it when you do it, because that steel is holding up the entire staircase up through the other three floors. So it was a big job. Looks nice now, but it was scary at the time. So it's been done from the top to the bottom. There were two huge chimneys on that roof. We had scaffolding all the way around it. I gutted it from top to bottom. It was a lot of work. There's 5 bathrooms in that building, 3 kitchens.
We've got a pot of our own money that we're going to begin doing deals with. We're going to be borrowing money from people that want to put money in as well. Because it's weird, you know, people have got cash in the bank. Some people have, that they don't know what to do with. They don't necessarily know about houses and building work and renovations and all the complexity that goes with it. A lot of people don't know how to do it, right?
Because actually, when you look, 5% on your money is really good.
Yeah.
And there's no hassle. They literally hand the money over and we hand them 105 back. They've made $5,000 this year for doing nothing.
What else were they going to do with that money?
And we also, what we do is, if we do it sooner than a year, we'll give them their money and the $5,000 back in 8 months. So then they've made even more. If we've made money and we've done it quickly, they can have their money back and their whole interest rate for the year. Yes, it's insane. Anyone who's got any money just sat in the bank, not earning any money, like, they are nuts not to do this.
I've known Alex since 2005, 14 years. And I've seen her go from just a normal person. She was a chef when I first knew her, working in a pub, right? And I've seen her start to coach people, because the way she started coaching is people were just asking her, how do you do this property thing? How are you doing it? Can you teach me? Can we meet up? Can you explain it to me? That's how it started. And she eventually transitioned into charging for her time, you know, because that's a natural progression. And then she was getting invited to go and give talks and seminars and keynote speeches. And then she started, you know, taking her coaching business more seriously and putting joint venture groups together. And it was just all a natural unfolding. And now she's got several joint venture groups that she coaches. I'm a member of one of them. And she coaches online as well. So if you're interested in learning from Alex, get in touch with her. We're not psyching ourselves up to do it. We're just doing it, you know? And it's a different thing. Love heart. Love bug. I love hearts.